So first, what are the services I mentioned, the syllabus? Can anyone remember? Blob we have mentioned, right? Blob storage and data lake and just databases and VM and the HD inside. And what else? Edge services, databases, HD Insight, VM, data lake, blob. Okay, this is only we have mentioned in the syllabus. So based on that, these services we are going to create. So the plan for session. Create the services step by step and then implementations with Python codes. How we can read the data, write the data, and the listed files, and all we are going to work it out with the storage. Services as well as via VM, what are the things we can interact with the other services. That's also we are going to see it. And some installation part with VM and SD inside. So everything we just go with implementation with the development environment. So how we are going to approach in the development practice, the same we are going to do here. So this is Python and Spark. So Spark code, this is we have planned. And implementation, once it is over properly, all the services. And finally, we are going to combine all services and create a sample project. So via HD Insight only, we are going to do it. But in HD Insight separately, we just discuss, and then only we are going to use as project service classes. So this is the agenda and plan that we are going to see it. Okay. Is this fine or any changes is needed? Is it okay, right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Okay, so data lake, mostly it's Gen 2 is a famous, but I will tell you the difference between Gen 1 and Gen 2. And why Gen 2 is useful nowadays. That is also we are going to discuss much. Okay, so this is the common about Azure. Before I enter the Azure, I forgot to ask you, why we need to move to cloud service? This is a common, right? So why we need to move to cloud services? What is the reason behind? You have some idea, right? Just we just discuss what is cloud, what are the things they are doing, and then very directly we can go for the session.
Could be environment, like services, everything is provided in cloud. Financially, it might be cheaper maintaining all the systems at data centers or on premises.
We can achieve a on-premise also, right? How it is cheap? How you are saying this is also cheap?
Because the maintenance cost is less.
Okay. So maintenance is the only reason to move to cloud?
No, that's not the only reason.
Okay, so no problem. So this is the on-demand delivery, we can do it via cloud environment. So whatever the services, it immediately we can use it. Let's example, I'm working in a big data platform. I need to integrate different services. So if it is on-premise, but I have to do, I want to install it properly, and then only the maintenance will come. And then if it is not required, I need to clean up the process and all. So the maintenance before that installation part and configuration part, this and all will come, right? That and all, they will be taken care of by them. So actually this cloud will be divided into multiple structure of the services. That is infra as a service, right? As a service. Just a minute, guys. Somebody's. Okay, so infra as a service, that's the first reason. Once we have the environment, that infrastructure we have properly. Infrastructure is nothing but your operating system environment. Properly you have that environment successfully, and then you have to install some softwares, right? So that is comes to SaaS platform. Software as a services. They are provided. And then you have a software, and then you want to do some analysis via some different application. So it's a API call or something, right? That will come to pass. Platform as a service. If suppose you want to work with Java integration or Python platform integration or something else. So such kind of platform level of API installation, everything they will give you. And additionally, DAS. Database as a service. So first configuration level, you have very less operation. If suppose you want to create any software, immediately you can do just a plug and play operation here. So infra as a services, you can see something with the VM, you can go with that. Software as a services, so you can consider and go with some what is the software I can say? Some implementation API related softwares, we can use it here directly. Platform, directly they will give you some marketplace related platform to you. Databases, a number of databases, they will be included. Just to plug and play, you can do that and create it. Once you create the services successfully, while you handle it, if suppose any problem will be arised. So what will happen? If anything is collapsed or is going to be down, something has happened. So that maintenance part, as he said, maintenance part entirely, they will be taking care. If any replication data or balancing the service and all, they will be taking care in the backend with some load balancing concept. The same we can achieve in on-premise. The problem is in on-premise, once it is over, we have to clean up everything and manage it. So until that, we need to install our own all the services and then follow it. So this kind of admin part completely reduced here. So that's a major reason every responsibility for the admin part, that own that service team will be taking this, not only for Azure, AWS and all. So what are the services you are going to use it in the backend, they will be taking that responsibility for 99% accuracy. It's not go further down at all. Like that, they will be providing the confidence. That's the reason we just migrate into the cloud. Okay. And this is the basics of cloud reason we have entered. And here also they will be providing some security level. But the problem in security with the cloud, it's actually it's not a correct. Whatever you'll be providing the confidence with on-premise, you cannot provide in cloud. But they are giving some additional security purpose. Some depends on your private network integration, they will give you, and OTP, multi-factor authentication. So okay, this one will come, right? Private network and MFA, multi-factor authentication. And multi-factor authentication. And the third one is something is very important. I forgot. Network level as well as the data level. And firewall. firewall implementation. These are all the services they will give you in the backend for your data security. But even though the problem is, if you are going to handle your data via cloud, you want to switch your data from one platform to another environment, sorry, one region zone to another region zone due to the replication and something. So what will happen? Your data will be lost from one country to another country. There is a lot of chances available. So that mainly the transaction related banking team, they will not be moving to the cloud environment. They are trying to avoid so much with to go with cloud. They will be trying to go with on-premise itself because data is very secure for them. Apart from the data is not big deal for the security related. So other services, sorry, other members of will be moved to the cloud. And majorly using up to 85% of margin, they have reached AWS. And then Azure is growing now. So most of the job opening, you can see, if it is a AWS, a lot of the people will be waiting the queue. But Azure isn't running now. Whoever have knowledge in Azure, immediately they will be selected. Because it's coming on the peak and it's grow across the countries. So you have very good opportunity if supposed to select and learn everything via Azure. Okay, because already AWS is in a matured stage. And GCP also one of the services, but GCP people will not be give more trust, but they are trying different ways to handle the data via their services. But even though the companies are not moving it, but still they are growing up. So last year also GCP have some losses in billion level. Apart from Azure and AWS, they have very good profit in this. So this major three cloud services across the countries, everyone is using. After that, Alibaba recently they have entered. Likewise, Oracle also cloud environment they have introduced, IBM also introduced. They are in chain. Depends on that project level, they will migrate and select the services and go forward. Okay, so just simple understand. Any question till now? Yeah, please.
No, I don't have any questions.
No question, right? Okay, just to simple understand why we have to go. That's it. We didn't go in depth in this. So next, we're just going to see Azure services, creations, and all. So first, we can see about Azure Blob creation. Who all have an account with Azure now?
I have one.
Okay. Because why I'm saying cloud environment, you have to do practice, then only it will help us. If suppose you don't have an account, you're just watching it, then it's not a good way. So try to create your own account and practice it. By default, for that Azure subscription, they will give you free subscription. Okay, this is a one-time trade. So up to 30,000 rupees level, they are giving you to handle the services. After that, once it is over, then only they will charging you from your credit card. While create this account, you have to mention your credit card definitely. Actually, the problem is in real time, most of the services we are not used, but for the practice purpose, we just enable and close it. So what are all you're not used, you're actually forget that one you just paid in the real time. So some cases it works out. Okay, so 30,000 rupees they will give you in our account, you can use it. Up to 12 months, they will give you the time. So be careful while using your services. Okay, so here, once you enter to the blog, what are the services you're going to use it before you want to create a resource group? Resource group is nothing, but it will be following all your resources, all your services in a group. That's it. So go to this, your actual platform. Microsoft Azure. This is the home page is available. Just click on it. You can see all the service information is available here. Click on all services. It will be reflect all the information properly. So if suppose you want to work with your computer, any VM related, any instance you want to create and use it, you can use this compute. Networking related, you want to create any services, the option available here. Storage level, this options is available. Like web, mobile, any Docker related container instance you want to register and use it. Database. So this many databases, you can use it in cloud. Analytics part, here's the insight. We is available, you can use it. As well, blockchain, AI, machine learning, IoT platform related. If suppose you want to create an IoT hub event or something, you can use it here. Okay, so first we just create a resource group. Why a resource group is needed? You can grouping all your services under to resource group for easy understanding purpose. So just go to the resource group here and add a resource group. Okay, so what are the subscription is available? You can select here. So there is a two subscription I am using in pay as you go and Azure subscription. This is also paid subscription, few services. So here you can mention what resource group you are going to create. What is the name of your resource group? So this is for I am using for October batch, right? October 2020. I'm going to use it. Just understanding. I'm entering, okay? So something, without spaces you want to provide, then only resource group, it should be unique. And then which region all your services belongs to that. Based on that, the region services you can select. So I just plan to go with, use to use is also so fine for me. I can mention it. And then tag. So tag is nothing but if suppose you are going to create a service inside, it will be supporting multiple services required while you are going to enable it. Example, you are going to start your virtual machine. This virtual machine, it will be creating the backend with the different services. Everything you should tag in the same name, right? So that's the reason they will give you the tag. It is, we can easily identify which is respect to what, like that. That's it. So that's the reason we are going to use it. So here I just mentioning batch and this is resource group. So I just mentioned resource group, OCT 20, understanding purpose, I just mentioned it. And go to review and create. In this page, all your information you can see. So what is the name of the subscription you are using, resource group, name you provided and region, which region you just plan to create it. And what is the tag you mentioned, batch and RG. This tag mainly used for your billing perspective. Suppose you are getting the billing, there you can identify which services used more and paid more. Like something like you can identify via your tag name only. Okay. Tell them any question.
No questions, Dinesh.
Okay. So everything is fine. You can validation is passed, then only you can create the services. Okay, now resource group is created. Resource group is just a group name only, so immediately it will create, no problem. Just inside go to this resource group. Okay, so resource group, you can come here or you can type here also, just a resource group something, it will come here. So that such particular service you can type, that will be referred. This is selected and then here you can add particular your service information. If I plan to create blob, right? So blob will come under two storage services. Okay, storage services. Data box, okay, it is in stored in a lot of the places. See all we can see. Yeah, storage account is not a blob. Actual name for blob is storage account. Sorry. So select choose your storage account. I can give the notes. Resource group. And then storages. Storage account and then create storage account. Why it is not okay? Okay, here automatically it will be locate your resource group, and under the subscription it just come here. You can provide your storage account name. So this is blob I'm going to create storage. Okay, it should comes with only lowercase blob storage. Okay, so I can mention OCT 20 blob storage, something I can mention. This is the name I'm going to use it. So location is available. Resource group, you just create which region. The same you can select, or if suppose you need different region, that is also you can select here. Okay, so example, I'm going to select the same location, and then performance. Performance is available in two ways. One is standard, another one is premium. So standard performance is like you can use your storage space with your normal disk places, or you want to, you have very hard data, so it's continuously using the data, that you should use via premium. Premium will come under to SSD hard disk something. So based on that, you can select. So you, based on your standard or premium, the other operation will be modified. Example, you can see, I'm selecting this standard. And so here storage available, storage is V1, V2, and blob storage is available. And you can see local redundancy, zone, GRS, read access, GRS, something is available. Now I just modified, and you can see this is the same is available, but here only they will be providing you to go with LRS. Local redundancy storage, because it's internally transfer the data across the places, that is come for premium. So premium is mostly used only for internal operation and the hard kind of operation only they will use it. But standard, you can replicate the data across your places and all. That's the benefit. You can go with standard. So standard blob storage is commonly available. Just select. So this is the way you can select this one based on the account type, how it is going to be worked out. So blob storage already, you know, right? Binary large object storage, that is the name for blob. So you can store all your data as a blob inside to that your disk, and you can retrieve it. So what is the best way? AWS account, they will go with object storage. Whatever the data, you're going to store it as an object. Azure account, everything, they will go with blob storage. So what is the difference between blob and object? Anyone tell me? Any idea? Blob and object. Okay, somebody mentioned chat. No.
There is something called archive.
I'm
not sure. There is something called archive data.
I'm not sure. Not like that. Binary large object, you can handle any your platform like Linux or Windows, any that particular infra platform, you can interact very faster. But object will not be doing like that. It is just an object. Blob data, you can edit your data entirely, but object, you cannot do that. Once you store the data, it's like object. Only you can read the data or move the data. That's it. But blob storage, you can modify the data because it's a backend. They will be using the block information only in the backend. So by default in Windows, there we go with 64 KB of the block sizes, and Linux there will go with the 4 MB block sizes. So based on your blob you selected, the block size will be interacted in the backend. So the fast paced, if you are going to think, blob is the best to compare with the object. Okay. So now next you can see locally redundancy storage. If suppose you're going to use the replication, the data, then local redundancy. Only you're going to use your all your data into US country only. US to US, right? The location you select. This region only you're going to use all your data, then LRS is fine. If suppose you're going to interact global level, you are going to store all your data from US, but it will be accessed from other place like Japan or some other country, Asia, you're going to access it. There you can select for GRS operations. So GRS is a global level geo redundancy. So the same data will be replicated other region zone, and you can handle it very faster. That's the reason you have to select this two. And third one is geo redundancy. They will give you only read access. If suppose you are going to read the write the data via East US region, that same data you can read only via from other region zone. You cannot edit anything. That will be edit operation is possible only in your East US region one. So such kind of that replication you can select based on that your blob, whatever the data you're going to store into this blob, it will be reacted. Okay. So for example, we just go with LRS. In real time, the project level, they are going to use it based on the use cases. They will be select for geo. Okay. Next, network level. Network level, you can provide the public endpoint to access all the network or secure network. If suppose only the respective people only, they have to access this block, you can select public endpoint with selected network only. Likewise, you can provide the network information. And private endpoint, only respective private VPC account only can access this storage level. Okay, like that it will be modified. You can select this a public endpoint to access any places to this environment, something like. Okay, and the network routing, message routing by default they will be provided internally. If suppose you want to route the data, IO operation in round robin, you can select for internet routing. Okay, but Microsoft will give the authority for it's a kind of concept is called ICMP concept, internet cross network protocol. They will give you the access. So based on that, you can select this option also. Okay. So storage account and then storage name you want to provide. Storage name, once you choose the storage name, select account type and then you can go with replications. Once it is over, then come to the networking, select communications. Choose network type. So mostly you will be playing basics and networking, mostly in real time. Okay, so based on your data rotations and the data selection, that accessibility selections, it will be modified. Now data protection, they will be providing the insight for data protection. If suppose any data you are going to delete it, that should be stored in some places. You can use for turn on this recovery options, soft delete. Soft delete means it will not be deleted. It will be stored in a temp file. Whenever you need, you can recover it. That is the use of soft delete operations. And tracking, I'm not using this. Soft delete, I know this. Next. Advanced security layer. If you want to provide access for SSL, TLS access, you can provide this security level access. And blob level access, you can provide. And Gen 2 is a simple hierarchical namespace you want to enable. And this blob you're going to use as a data like Gen 2, you can enable the services. This is we are going to see in while creating the service with your data like Gen 2. Okay, and tables and queues is available. Based on this selection, the tables and queues will be available. So whatever the data you're going to store it directly, you can read the data as a tables. You can do that. As well as queues will be create and integrate with other platform, you can use it. While we are going to discuss about a Snowflake, right? There we are going to use this queues to transfer the data via Snowpipe to Snowflake environment. At the time, I will show you a little detail this one. Okay, next tag is referred for your information. So batch I just mentioned, and I can mention this one is blob. Okay, so what all you will be selected, all the information will come to here. Okay, everything we cannot select. So this was also a major thing, right? This is what I can give you. Oh, it's not coming properly. Okay, so subscription, resource group, which resource group you are going to create it, which location, storage account name, you provided the storage account name and deployment model, resource manager, we just mentioned it, account type, blob storage, LRS, it's a locally redundant policy based, we just replicate the data, and performance is standard. If it is a premium, only LRS is available, geo redundancy they will not be giving you. Because it's a premium, it will be a little different. So rest of that is the same. By default connections only we just provide here. I'm going to create the service. It takes some time, yeah, and then it will be created. Now the service is create. The backend will be running, right? You can check here. Deployment is in progress. In notification, you will get all the information. Once service is ready, you can verify. Till now, any question? Yeah, any question?
No, from my side.
Okay, so service is ready. Go to the resource group. Go to your resource group directly, and you can see once service is created, it will reflect here where it is. Yeah, now it comes, right? So this service belongs to this resource group you just created. You suppose you want to delete all the services at one time, just select everything and delete, or delete resource group, that's it, all the service will be deleted. So simple way, you can delete all your services via this delete resource group. Same like in AWS also is available, resource group creation, and you can create all your services. Now it's available. I just enter into the object, this blob. Now you can see the containers is available. So container is nothing but inside the blob storage, they will store all the data based on the container only. You can scale the data properly via containers. Okay, because it's a blob, right? So what are the data you're going to store it via container only, you can do that. And the same like I have Azure. One more thing, Azure Storage Explorer is available. Based on this tool also, you can access this data. So this tool you want to install, then only it will come. Okay, it's reading now. You want to install this Azure Storage Explorer. Based on that, you can interact with your data faster. Okay, the same data in VBA you can see via containers. Just click into the containers. No data is available. no containers available. Once you create the container, then only you can rewrite your data or read your data. So first I'm going to create a container, blob container. So container name should be in unique. It will be accessed via across the worldwide. So you want to provide your container name properly, blob container, and then OCT20. Okay, I just mentioned access level, you can provide private level or blob level or container only. So based on that, it will be modified. So private, no anonymous. Based on you have access for this storage account, they will be select this container also. Okay, so encryptions, no other information. Based on your access level changes, it will be modified. Only for read-only access, you want to provide this container, you can select this one. Now just create the container. Now container is ready. Container also is a kind of, how can I say? It's a folder, okay? Okay, so now I just create the services that storage, right? Just refresh. Yeah, you can see there's a blob we have created, right? Just before. OCT blob storage. So this is the application that you can download and install in your Windows and directly you can see. What are the thing you just load in, it will be verified here first. So blobs and tables, both is available. Based on the, your data you want to access as a table only, you can use it. Blobs based to container based you can you want access, then you can select this one. Now no data is available. Now I just go inside. And if suppose I want to create and upload any data directly, empty folder you cannot create directly. While load any data, that time you can create your folders. Okay, just selecting my file. Example file I'm going to select from. Sample use case or sample data, right? We have. Okay, just to select this table file and click on this advanced. There you can see what is the block type you are going to use it. This block based you are going to load it. And block size also you can select. It will come from 64KB to 100MB based on the block size you can select and create this container. By creating this container, the block will be reacted for your data. So it depends on your data size. You can select your blob size also. So by default is of 4KB is available. Now I'm going to create the sample file only, right? I just create 1MB file based. And there's a tier is available, hot path and cold path. Hot path is nothing but the data will be stored into this environment. You can continuously access it. Then it will be the caches. Everything will be stored in the temp memory itself. Or if suppose you're going to select in some cool places, the data will be, once the data will be migrated, it will be freezed, the temp memory. And the archive third one is available. If suppose you're not using this data very randomly, you're going to select, then you can select your archive type. So by default, and inferred with hard path only. So based on that, I just select hard. And upload to the folder. If suppose you want to load this data into this any folder, you can mention here. Let's example, I'm going to use sample data set. This data set I'm going to load into, this is a patient data, right? So I just mentioning patient. So data set is a kind of directory. Inside patient, another directory will create, and then this data will be uploaded into this directory. Likewise, you can select it. Directly, there is no option to select and create the folder. Via this way, you can do that. Okay, any question? Can I proceed?
Yeah, Dinesh.
Now we can see 270 that size of data only. It is just uploaded successfully 273 bytes of data. Now you can open it, and the folder you can open it, and you can see the data. Now just click the data, and you can view your data success completely here. Where it is the option here, then edit. So what kind of data you have stored that is possible to visible here? What happened? Yeah. And in Azure, you can edit your data successfully. Example, if suppose I want to edit and change some data and store it again, I can simply save it. Just to, instead of 31, I just mentioned for 51, for example purpose, it is updating here again. So such things is possible in your Azure platform. Due to this is create everything as a blob storage. But AWS, you cannot do anything. Only you can write the data as an object. So once the object data will be stored, it cannot do any changes. So this is a major difference between the Azure and AWS. Okay, it's available. Now it's successfully modified. If suppose you want to download the data, directly you can download it. Okay, any question? Same data you can visual here also. Just click on it. Just refresh. Here Azure Storage Explorer, you can copy the data or directly upload the data, something you can do. The edit operation will not be available directly. Okay, so if suppose I want to upload any data, just to sample another file, I'm going to upload here. Okay, it's transferring now. Via command AZ copy also you can achieve it. For command practice, we didn't go. We just go only for references. Now the same, you can come back here and refresh the tab, it will be different. So like that, you can do the communication between your Azure environment successfully. Okay, so this is the way you can create your services in Azure Blob and you can use it. Any question? Next, we are going to run and read the data via Python code using Pandas and Spark and all, right? That's where we are going to see it. So till now, any question we can discuss again, or we can go forward. Hope no question.
No questions.
Okay, those who have access, so just create and practice this all, which will help to recover. Okay, because this all is in real time, you're going to do it. Now this is available. The data will be stored successfully. And if suppose you want to delete any data, just select and delete. It automatically will be deleted from this directory. And access level changes, if anything is needed, you can do that also. The same while upload the data, right? The same you can do the changes also here. It's like a read-only or execute level access you want to provide, you can do that. And then access policy, based on the access policy, you can access your data. Okay, you can create the access policy. Based on the access policy, you can read the data and you can use it. IAM is a kind of control management. If, suppose you want to provide the access only for this blob, for particular people, you can provide the access via role assignments. Role assignment is nothing but it's like a policy access. If suppose you know the user, that user only access to this container, to this folder only, you can provide access based on this role assignment. So based on that, he can access it. Anybody have account? Just give me your name. I can give access to this, for example. Okay, so roles is nothing but particular user have what kind of role it is, based on that it will be moved. So if suppose these are all the roles is available, so roles based you can provide access. Roles is a kind of as a bulk policy access you can provide. This is role assignment is a kind of policy access only can provide to the particular user. That's the difference between these two. Role is a top hierarchy, role assignment is a policy hierarchy. Only you want to read the data, you can provide the reader access, or he is a owner to handle all the data, delete everything, you can do it, then you can provide owner. Or only data handling, you can, he can use all the data, but he cannot, he won't delete the data, then you can provide as a contributor. Something like these are other options available, based on that you can select it. Okay, storage account based by, what is that? Blob contributor, blob data owner, blob reader owner. Only for this blob have to provide the access, you can select this. Okay. So just to go and select, add role assignment. And what kind of role you are going to provide, the owner, contributor, something like. First role, you can select the role. Only I want to provide the read only access, I can select it. And what kind of user I want to provide the access, a group or service principal, something is available. Based on that, I can provide the access. If I have an email who have account already with Azure account, I can provide their email, then they can access it. I can add their email ID here and click on save, automatically the access will give to them. Then they can go to their resource group, sorry, their environment, and select their resource group. Under that, they can see this blob storages. That also will create the same resource group name. Under that, they can see that services information. That's the reason why creating the resource group and all, it should be unique. Okay. So now, till now, we just see how to create the container and load the data something. Now we're just going to see to read the data. We can read the data via pandas, Python code and all. We are going to see in some time. Okay, any question? Yeah, you can create a free account. Just go to this Azure portal. Okay, Microsoft Azure. Create your free account today, something, right? Just click on it and create all the services. Not the services you want to, but you should need a credit card, then only you can do that. Okay, so start free or buy now. So just click start free. Thank you. Okay, so already I am in sign up, so that's the reason it won't allow. Better, I will do one thing. I'm just going to here also have account, right? Incognito mode, I'm just going to enable it. Azure free account. Okay, provide the user ID, email ID and all, and automatically they will create the account. You want to fill the form properly. You have need a Microsoft account or Gmail account also is fine. You want to sign in properly and then you want to fill that all the information, then only they will give you access. Okay, and within a 1 month, you want to confirm your credit card. Otherwise, they will not allow you to use the entire services. So some restrictions available. So within a 1 month, you can do a rough operation, so fine. More than 1 month, you want to be very careful and use it. Actually, Azure or any cloud practices, what you are going to use it, that will not be paid. What you forget to use it, that only you're going to pay it in real time. So please be careful what are the services you're going to use it at the end. If it's not required, just terminate. Because they will be charged hourly basis or monthly basis, so please be very clear. Okay, so here I can see. So if suppose you want to go into the subscription, there you can see billing options is available under to the subscription. There you can get all the information properly. So you can see this is also pay as you go offers. And this much I have used right now for this current month something. So how much that each services used, everything you can visualize here. Okay. You can get the monthly bills on something. Best on that, you can use it. Free tier, it will be mentioned as a free something. Okay. Any other question? Any question, guys? Okay, so we can take 10 minutes break and then we can start and go forward with the Python programming integration with this blob data. How we can access from outside environment to this blob and read the data properly and all, we are going to see it. Okay. Is it okay or something else?
No, that's okay.
Okay, so it's 5:35. We can connect back after 10 minutes, 5:45 sharply. We can go forward. Okay, I just stop recording, so the sharing screen.